A new problem in Fort Myers. The arsenic found at a former toxic dump site has spread. Testing in the area around South Street shows the arsenic has been detected outside the originally suspected site. NBC2's Julian Dell has been working to find out what this means for the people who live in that area.
That's right. The city's newly released report shows levels are up to 3 times higher than EPA standards off-site. The new revelation has residents even more concerned and looking for answers.
Is the water clean enough to drink?
That's what residents want to know after the city's most recent report shows high levels of arsenic in the off-site wells around South Street. The latest report has many wondering just how much arsenic there is.
And I'm like, where is it? Has it stopped?
Teresa Hamilton lives across from the site and says her water smells like sulfur when she turns it on.
We drink in this water, we bathe in this water, and it smells.
She believes it's coming from the toxic sludge site.
So when it rain across the street, as it drop, we could smell it. So I know it's something over there.
She says the people in this area need answers.
The neighbors need to know how they're going to fix this and what we need to look forward to.
Jamar Hillard has lived in Dunbar his whole life and says what information they've been mailed by the city just isn't enough.
It still doesn't really completely show what's going on and is it safe.
So without knowing, residents say they're taking extra precautions.
I gotta buy more water, boil more water. And I don't even know if boiling the water is really good or not.
But they're still concerned about their health.
Cooking, eating, drinking, brushing your teeth. It's hazardous.
And want to know, what's next?
I mean, I'm okay now, but what about the future? You know, what about my kids? It does make me worry going forward.
We reached out to the mayor and city manager. They both said they don't want to comment until they have the full results. Ward 2 Councilman Johnny Street says he will be holding a press conference on Thursday about the toxic site. Live in the control room, Julianne Dell, NBC2.